Hey guys, welcome to another commentary done by Diggity. We're back on Fighting Spirit Mania. Upper right-hand corner, we got Bonyth starting as the red Protoss. Upper left-hand corner, we've got Dewalt starting as the yellow Protoss. If you want to see the map, you can. But you're going to see a lot of it. Yeah, natural expansion. I'm trying to think if there's been something that's even mimicked this design. Like, we've seen Neo-Dark Origin and other maps like that, Destination, that have kind of done the bridge split out and kind of made it interesting where there is sort of a protected third. But yeah, the Fighting Spirit honestly has had a massive influence on things, on map design for a very long period of time. It was very, very popular. Second announcement, if you have not checked it out already, Day 9 had the favorite son of the StarCraft community, which is hard to say, actually, because there are a lot of favorite sons of the StarCraft community, so maybe I should say a favorite son of the StarCraft community, is back casting Brood War again on his channel. Be sure to check that out. Also be able to check him out on YouTube. I'm very excited. I'm hoping, actually, we'll be able to sneak him into BSL, potentially, or some other sort of stuff. Or who knows, maybe he's in the know, and Microsoft is planning cool things for StarCraft. One can hope. And if I could sneak into that, that would be amazing. We'll see. Bonyth, I don't know, by the way. I'm just hoping right there. Bonyth looks like he's going to go for a cross-map scout. Thing about Fighting Spirit is it is possible to go for proxy two gate in the middle of the map, which is a strong build, a challenging build to defend as Protoss. However, a lot of time what you will see is double gateway interior to base, and that does seem to be Bonnet's go-to build, mostly what he's known for. Quirk actually has a very long discussion of this build in particular, which is very informative if you hunt it down and want to find it, or you can poke him and ask about it. Looks like we do have a cybernetic score opening here for Dewalt. Part of the advantage of this is if you can, excuse me, still a little bit stuffed up, if you can get zealots in your opponent's base, oftentimes what happens with this build is you can kill off enough workers, end up with enough lack of a response that you have a overall economic lead and an inability for your opponent to respond with the opening. So you end up kind of with a overall worker lead. Interesting here, though, usually you'll see that gas grabbed a little bit later. So it looks, but and usually is kind of a half decision of like, okay, are we going three zealot or not? Bonyth going for the gas pretty rapidly here before his third pylon, and before, and he's definitely decided before the fourth and fifth zealot right here. So no pause whatsoever. He's like, yep, definitely going to go into gas after the initial three zealots. First Dragoon on the way. There was no preventative zealot on the front, so it's going to be a challenge to, or sorry, there was. So it's going to be a challenge to defend. And the more damage that can be done on this probe, the better, because it can get involved in the fight as well, particularly messing up the Dragoon. Manor Pylon as well are ready, and the Zealot's still not covering the ramp, which is huge. And now the Zealot's making their way in. Dewalt just now sees the double Pylon. The Dragoon, oh, pinned into the corner instantaneously. That is bad news for Dewalt. So Zealot gets a very rapid kill. Shield battery now at the natural, or sorry, in the main. The Pylon gonna get dropped. But that's three Zealots versus one, and this is going to be a very, very challenging defense for Dewalt overall. So now no longer mining gas. He does have enough gas to potentially get some additional Dragoons out. The Zealot doing a pretty good job of engaging here. He's going to get back and get some additional energy. This is, keep in mind, 100 minerals that were dropped and not going to be all that useful past this as well. So potentially already successful. But right now, Dewalt has not bled, or he's managed to, so he's already down workers, but he's not, it's not as bad as it usually would be. And mostly it looks like it's going to be a hit of gas. And as I say that, another worker goes down. So already successful for Bonyth right here. So forced a shield battery. He's got a two, maybe soon to be three worker lead, and was able to jump right back in to get a gas advantage as well. So now three worker lead. This is exactly how you want this to execute. So now you got two Dragoons, but already two Dragoons out on Bonyth's side of the map. And that's how that build works. Range upgrading as well. Range now finished, I believe, for Dewalt. Oh, never mind. He might have canceled there to drop the robotics facility to follow. So it looks like this is going to be a two-gate robo follow-up. I didn't see whether that was a finish of range or whether that was a a cancellation of range, unfortunately. My eyes aren't that fast. And my brain, not that sharp right this second. Will be in the future. Dragoon's now cycling out, checking things out. Is Bonyth going to... So it looks like he's going to go ahead and drop a natural. So he's got his two gateways up. Not going to go for two gate beyond this. Pylon plays, sometimes this speeds up gas. I think it might speed up gas on this map in particular. So natural getting grabbed. That will give Bonyth an overall economic lead. And this is dangerous for Dewalt. He's moving out a Dragoon to provide that scouting information. He's going to get trapped and deep into enemy territory. And he was already potentially down. So yeah, now getting swarmed. But he does see the Dragoon count. So trying to flee to the north. Unfortunately gets pinned. Loses another Dragoon. So now it's going to be 3 versus 6 with a bit of a delay and Dewalt trying to hold the high ground. And you have an expansion behind this for Bonyth. So Bonyth way ahead all of a sudden. Probe trying to provide a little bit of an additional buffer. And look at that probe being vicious. A Dragoon, yeah, one down already. The second one picked off immediately. Still 5 on the low ground. 2 additional Dragoons making it a little bit better. The probe finally taken out to even things up. And now that shield battery really matters. So where I thought that wasn't going to be a big factor, now maybe it's going to save Dewalt the game. But the build has been spotted. 2 Dragoons versus 1 remaining. 2 potentially going to spawn, but now it's a full rally. The thing is, even if Dewalt holds this, which he isn't, yeah, GG right there. You have that natural expansion building in the background. So now 1 apiece in this vicious PvP. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Thanks for listening.